All right, we're gonna measure the whole countertop across. We've got a 4-inch rise, so we're gonna go 64.
Right.
And then just to calculate it as a square, we'll do a 64 by 64.
Yeah.
You can do it by 78 by 51. Going real dark like the other ones did? That's not as close.
No. No. A little bit more density.
And now we'll have a place for the TV. And
it takes a little more friction to break the surface tension. Mm-hmm. So you just rub it, and if it doesn't turn dark and penetrate, you'll see it. Now, as I'm rubbing this, rub that with your hand. You feel those bumps? Usually that's silicone or epoxy 45.
Yeah.
And just, you know, slightly wipe it. And what I can do is I can find all of the debris that's laying on top of this, and then just slide it off.
Is it advisable to use steel wool?
No.
No.
You want to make sure all the residue's gone, mm-hmm. and there's no streaking left over.
Sure.
See the shine pop?
Yep.
Now it's ready to cure. See how the stone is still darker than when we first? It's because it's absorbed a lot of sealant.
Okay.
Very coarse. Now I can feel debris right along here. Thing, if you can seal a countertop before the faucets go in and the hole is open, now's the time to just coat it inside very well.
Right.
Get the sealer in there, and if it's a soap hole dispenser,
sure.
You want to get clear caulking, and you want to rub that inside the hole.
Oh, okay.
And that way it'll keep the soap from soaking in sideways.
Okay.
And see how dark this has gone?
Sure.
This is very porous. The thickest polymer that we use.
Mm.
And so what we're going to do is we're going to coat all these first. Then we're going to go in and seal the floor and let these cure. And once we're done in there, we'll come back out and put the final four steps on. You're just drying.
Right.
The spinning action actually increases the circulation, which dries it faster to give us that drying I was talking about. Another way, another way to do your edge
yep.
is you can just use your towel.
Okay, I'm in.
Well, you remember how much seal was in this bottle when I started? It was right here.
Okay.
So then we use a couple ounces.
And that's going to be a sort
of 80 square feet. And then we're going to just throw a towel down on the ground.
Mm-hmm.
And we're just going to muff it. Just like that. Now one caution you have to make is up against the wall,
right.
You do not want to get your sealer on their wood.
Wood.
The reason for that is when the painter comes in behind you,
right.
The paint runs off the wall.
Okay.
It will not stick. So you want to get close, just do your grout lines. See how they go dark instantly?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so you know you're getting it. Okay, and you do, well, this one they've painted up to the line. But normally there's grout right there, so you want to just shoot the grout. Yeah, it's about 50%. Just start buffing it off. You can start on this side down here.
Oh, yeah, I did that one already.
You already went on it.
Yeah.
We have streaking left over from applying the sealer right here. So in order to get that off, all we have to do is reapply. Just spray it on
and
then take it off and rub it until it disappears.
Yeah, all the side effects like
that. And see, if you just wipe like you're washing, you're not taking the sealer off. You're just wiping it.
Mm-hmm.
And then it dries in place and it creates a hard surface. And so you have to re-wet it and then buff it till it's gone. Squirt it on, rub it in. Should push it in the pores. Get it all covered. And then move on to the next one. Too fast. 50% dry. Always. You gotta wait for it. Doing that technique, you'll use 1 to 2 ounces for the whole kitchen. It's the same thing, just cup your hands, spray it in. And then just rub it in. And this one is an immediate cure. So you just take your towel, wipe it off. In with this one, microfiber it. And it's done. Go ahead and feel that. And take your glove off. And now go feel the one that we haven't done yet.
Well, one thing I noticed that when the guys came out, they didn't do as nice a job as you do, because I remember that we had a little bit of steel with glue and so forth here, and they didn't take it off.
Yeah.
I had to go in and do it myself.
Yeah, that's what
So did you notice a difference?
That's why we use a glove. We feel it, and we feel that one.
Oh, you can see the sheen. It's probably the thing.
Yeah, you can see the shine, huh?
Oh, yeah. You can see the shine right away.
And that's the permanent chemical that makes granite shell granite.
Now wait till you fill it with the clean and shine.
Oh, yeah, then it gets even better. First started, I told the lady, I said, this little strong, you may want to leave the room. She says, let me smell it. She says, I drink that every Friday. I'm going to swipe it on and then wipe it off.
And now this is the step after Christochine.
Afterwards, I've got to use a fluorescent cleaner, and that'll scrub all the white stuff off, and then it'll push it back into the stuff. And then I'll come in with a water-based sealer that'll penetrate. I prefer sealing in the house versus sealing in a factory.
Yeah.
This is Silica Bright Cream, and what it does is it's a restoration oxidation remover. It's for glass, hard water spots, and stainless steel. What you do is apply it to a clean towel. And then you go with the grain of the stainless. If you look at this, it's going sideways, so you do not go against the grain. All you do is go back and forth with the grain, rubbing the Silica Bright into the material, and it will instantly take the oxidation out. So you roll it over and you continue. If it's real bad, again, you see we got more out, so we're going to just add a little bit more. The battery died?
Yeah, you can send me now.
And we'll do
so
it
you're
one
just
more.
Applying again?
Yeah, I'm just going to apply it again, get more oxidation out. The trick is flat, even palm to give it an even look. Okay, and then I'm going to do the front of this here. I'm just going to clean off the residue. I'm going to apply the Christochine. And just rub it in. See how it changes the patina of it?
Mm-hmm.
And then it takes off more oxidation. Put it on your rag. Take clean and shine.
Spritz it.
So what does the crystal sheen do then?
It replaces the oxygen with a carbon crystal, so okay. You're stopping the oxidation.
Okay.
Then you just rub this on. Just start over again. You know, to say, oh, I'm not satisfied with what I got. So even though you've done all your treatments, you can start over. And again, stainless is very fickle. It has imperfections, it has stains, it has all kinds of stuff in the metal.
Right.
So you can't get all of it out because you can't remake. We just finished 300 square feet of flooring with our floor sealer. And we just did 80 square feet of granite with only 2 ounces of chemical, which created the granite shield finish that you see on this countertop.